Hey all, it's Professor Dave. I want to continue talking about elimination reactions, specifically the E1 reaction.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So the E1 reaction is to the E2 reaction, as the SN1 reaction is to the SN2 reaction. So basically, as you'd expect, the E1 reaction is going to be two steps with a unimolecular transition state. So just like with the SN2, just like for the SN1, the first step in the E1 reaction is that the leaving group leaves. So let's take a look at this substrate here. The bromine is going to leave. That leaves a tertiary carbocation. Now, it's very, very important to understand that while this substrate, this carbon is sp3 hybridized and therefore has tetrahedral geometry, anytime a carbon that is sp3 hybridized loses an electron domain, right, because this bromine is leaving with the electrons in that bond, now this carbon atom has only three electron domains, and anything surrounded by three electron domains will exhibit trigonal planar geometry. So it is the case that this methyl group is now flat in the board. This is now a flat molecule with respect to the carbons. And so there is a formal positive charge now. And so that means even a weak nucleophile like water can go ahead, do an acid-base reaction, and grab that proton. So here is oxygen interacting with this proton. And then the electrons in this carbon-hydrogen bond are the ones that go to form the carbon-carbon pi bond in the product. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me with questions, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.